Hello, ladies and gentlemen. We are going to talk tonight about an implementation of a flipped learning method in Hellenic Open University. So, a few words about our module. The Healthcare Management postgraduate course in Hellenic Open University comprises of four modules, and I teach in the second one, which is with yellow, you see, letters, and it's called DMY51. It is called Healthcare Services, Hospitals, Peculiarities and Challenges. So, in this one moment, πώς πάει κάτω αυτό. Ποιο, αυτό.
Δεξιά, αριστερό, μπρος, πίσω. Κανονικά θα πρέπει να πέσει και κόλλησε το πρόγραμμα.
Κόλλησε. Γιατί δεν πάει.
Κόλλησε. Αυτό μου πούσε να κλειστώ σε μόνο.
Κόλλησε η παρουσία. Κόλλησε ο υπολογιστής. Όχι.
Ούτε με escape γίνεται.
Να κάνω control delete.
Μήπω θέλει με τα password να μπει κανεί μέσα, δεν ξέρω.
Ποιο?
Το mouse.
Σιγά, σιγά, σιγά.
Και πώ θα πηγαίνει η
και μετά με αυτό, μάλλον με αυτό, ε.
Έλα, ξεκίνησε.
Α, τώρα τα πήρε όλα.
Με αυτό εδώ, με αυτό. Να έχει τα πολλά, να από εκεί.
Ναι, καλύτερα με αυτό.
Και έχει και.
Τέτοιο να δείχνω.
Σκοπευτήριο μπροστά.
Σκοπευτήριο. The areas of our module are these four things, as you see. And okay, our teaching method in this module is blended learning, which is a hybrid that combines both online, it means distance education, and face-to-face class time. This is happening during the counseling group sessions. The GCS, which are made five times through the year, through the academic year, and they are not compulsory. So a few words about blended learning. As we know, blending is mix something. It's a kind of learning that contains blends. And as Garrison and Kanuka have said, is the thoughtful integration of face-to-face learning together with online learning. On the other hand, flipped learning or inverted classroom or flipped classroom is another way of learning. That means to prepare material before class, to share it then with students, and to implement it inside the class. However, according to Flip Learning Network, flip learning means that instruction moves from the group to the individual, and the result, all this result is transformed into a dynamic, interactive learning environment. So, considering the importance of the face-to-face learning, in order that students could communicate, interact, and reflect. And the few studies that examine together flip learning in blended learning, so we extended in Patras, where I teach the DMY51 module, we extend a model of blended learning together with flip learning. And I believe that the blending with purpose module by Pisciano fits very well to this implication. Now, you're going to see what I mean. This model has six objectives. And in each objective, we have implemented a flip learning. The first one is content. As you see here, this cycle is content. And we did this thing. We flipped the GCS by two ways. to the predefined material. So into the class, the CGS, activities are given to answered not by each student, but by student groups. And second, all the answers that were given by the groups into the flipped CGS are posted later to the course, not only by students, but by the tutor too. The second one, the second objective in this model is dialectic and questioning. And this, we have implemented it into the flipped CGS with quizzes. And on the other hand, not into the flipped CGS, but during the teleconference meeting, we have implement virtual classes. So the next is the next objective is synthesis and evaluation, and we have made these two things into the flipped CGS. We have asked from students to present their work, and also inside the face-to-face classroom, some answers to basic issues are given by students, interaction, not only one by one, but divided in groups. And so we have discussion, live discussion during the CGS. Here you see the three other objectives of this model, blended with the purpose, which is reflection, collaboration, and social and emotional support. Besides this social and emotional support, which is given by portal and forums, both others, reflection and collaboration, are implemented during the flipped CGS by group activity. So, and this was the theoretical schema that we have applied. And during this academic year, I have met a lot of good things. I saw disagreements between students, I saw differences, but all of them, they were very challenging, very engaging, very lively, and so they were thought-provoking. Now, we have made a study to explore the perceptions of students of the effectiveness of flipped CGS, not only during, but before and after it. We have made a study, a research. This research was taking place in Patras, in my classroom, during the last CGS. And 17 students that were there present were administered a questionnaire that comprises of 8 questions of a 5-point Likert scale questionnaire and 4 open-ended questions. And the research questions were 3. What were the students' perception of the effectiveness of the flipped CGS? What were the students' perception of the usefulness of teleconference meeting to help them to written assignments? And what are the students' recommendations about advantages, disadvantages, whether they prefer a traditional CGS versus flipped, and recommendation for improvements. So there were 4 questions, as you see here, that they search engagement, interaction, modules, motivation to learn, 3 about activities, quizzes, and importance of video, and 4 open-ended, and 1 about students' perception of teleconference meeting. Students' demographics are shown in this table. Only 17, it's a small, of course, number. But let's see the results, which are very, very interesting. Most of them, the mode as you see here in median, are agree and strong agree that flipped CGS is more engaging than traditional. Activities inside the flipped CGS offer them greater opportunity for communication. The third question, they like to watch regularly the modules material in video type, agree also. And also agree that activities during the flipped CGS motivate them more. However, And yes, and they like to watch the CGS presentations, including the discussion. But here it's an interesting finding. They were asked if they would rather have, if they prefer to have a traditional tutor presentation than taking prior quizzes in home, at home, after watching a video. Most of them, you see here, 50 about percent, they have no opinion. And we try to explain this thing. And probably it is because of the inexperience of adult people of taking prior quizzes home alone, because adult students feel they need to be more self-directed. And most of the students in our sample were between 40 and 50 years old. And I believe that also they feel a lack of confidence outside of the class. But if the if the learning material in video have improved their ability in written assignments, they said yes, and they agree, the majority of them. And they also find that this teleconference meeting between CGS and the delivery of a written assignment is a very, very good thing for them. It's very helpful. They agree. And there was, as you see here, not one disagreement. So about the four open-ended questions that they found a lot of things, advantages. They think they wrote down, the students, that the flipped CGS provide knowledge enrichment and increase the communication with peers and with tutor. And they like to see videos, doing quizzes, but not home, but inside class. About disadvantages, most of the students met problems with ICT. Videos, they say, they are impersonal and there is no interaction. And there is not enough time, some of them said, to participate due to family issues and professional. If they prefer traditional versus flipped, they wrote a lot of good things, more personalized learning experience, increases students' interaction, provides student knowledge directions. And the recommendation in the teleconference meeting were surprisingly very good. They ask to be provided more frequently, and they must be scheduled from the beginning of the academic year and not by emails or phone between tutor and the students. And the platform must be, this is a Saba platform, and really it's a difficult platform for students, but it has to be more simpler. And concluding, these are, I have gathered them, all the results, what they say about Flip CGS. Most of them I have already told you. And I must say the limitation is this research, which is, I had a very small sample, only 17 students. I have not, I would like next year to try to find connections between students' achievements in written assignments and in final exams and the flipped CGS. And of course the questionnaire that I used has not been tested yet for reliability and validity. But I hope during next year I will do it. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. If there are any questions from the audience, I would like to ask you something. How does the workload for the tutor compares with the flipped CGS and the traditional teaching methods?
There is a lot of work to be done by the tutor prior CGS, and it's not in the traditional way. We have prepared a lot of videos, but not only videos, just to say something about learning material, but to prepare issues about topics about written assignments, and to find answers prior the student ask.
One more question, if you please. Once you do the initial investment, that means you prepare the questionnaires, the videos and stuff like that, how much effort does one need to keep it running? Can it be, can the workload be lessened by routine, or you have continued to input work in the program?
We continue every time, because all topics are never the same. I mean, all the written assignments are never the same. So we have to prepare new work and go on. And I believe next year we're going to show more results about it.
If there are no more questions from the audience, I would like to
just close the remarks. Just that before you use any questionnaire as a tool in order to extract some data that can be useful for planning of future educational procedures, it's good to do the validation, because I would suggest before you do, you implement the same questionnaire for students next year, you better validate the questionnaire so that you can use it and be able to actually publish what you use in order to be able to actually extract useful conclusions. Otherwise, if you don't validate it, besides the small sample size, there'd be a lot of bias introduced. So your next action should be validation, really.
It is our first step, but you know, we had not. I had not a lot of time to prepare for this work to validate it. But it's our first work job to do. Thank you.
And I think this concludes this session. Thank you very much. Have a nice afternoon.